Over 100 years ago, socio-political events on the Indian subcontinent erased the pattern of life followed by indigenous tribes. Even after India's independence, they found it difficult to find a place within the new socio-political structure. The Indo-Global Social Service Society felt the need to work with these tribes, the core idea being to empower communities to bring them into the mainstream of society without losing the essence of their tribal culture. Certain programs with nomadic tribes in the southern and western regions showed tremendous results within the framework IGSSS created.
IGSS works with marginalized communities, and nomadic tribes are one of the most marginalized communities because they include the nomadic tribes and also what we call the denotified tribes.
The Lambadas are one such nomadic tribe settled in pockets in the Mehbub Nagar district of Andhra Pradesh. They lacked basic education, had low income generating livelihoods, and migrated out of the area they adopted as their home for long periods of time in search of work. Regular sources of income in towns and villages were closed to them. They only knew very basic methods of agriculture to help sustain them. Most petty thefts were an outcome of a lack of a sustainable source of food or income. IGSSS looked at supporting and funding a project in this region for the Lambada tribes in 1994. The challenge was to empower the women of the house so that inroads in basic education and programs to enhance their income through readily available livelihood options could be made easier.
The Reeds area was nearly having 83,000 population. Among 83,000, nearly 33% consisting of Lambada tribals. The literacy rate was very, very low. It was 8% among the general, and it was just less than 3% among the Lambada women.
This is a typical primary school close to Chettupalli Tanda. Today, there is a definite jump in the number of children going to regular school from the Lambada community. The presence of tribal Lambada teachers has also played an important part in encouraging parents to send their children to school. Programs such as non-formal education, training, and capacity building initiated by IGSSS went a long way in creating this change.
ఇంకా నేను ఈ స్కూల్ ఈ స్కూల్ చెప్పి పిల్లల గ్రోత్ చెప్పి అనుబంధ పోషకారం వండి పిల్లలకు శుభ్రంగా నీట్గా చెప్పి మా భాషలనే వాళ్ళకి అర్థమైనట్లు పాఠాలు పెద్దలు వాడిపించి ఇంకా నేను అంగన్వాడీలో జాయిన్ సార్ వ్యవసాయం చేయకుండా ఈ స్కూల్కి వచ్చి రోజు ఇక వచ్చి చెప్పి వెళ్ళిపోతున్నాం మాకు ఇప్పుడు మంచిగానే ఉంది సార్ అంగన్వాడీలో చేసినందుకు ఇక ఎండలో పోవటం లేదు నీడలనే ఉండి మంచిగా చదువుకొని వాళ్ళకి కొంచెం
IGSSS first intervention in agriculture in this region was to first help provide good seeds for sowing and providing training workshops on how to improve quality produce by using better methods of farming.
IGSS, by seeing the progress of the work, they told me that instead of just agricultural activity, you go for integrated crop management for sustainable agriculture.
IGSSS studied and learned that a vicious cycle gripped this region. Farmers did not know the right methods of cultivation, pest management, and prevention methods. They depended very heavily on local traders to provide them with chemicals and other products to treat their fields in times of a pest attack. Prohibitive costs led to loans and debts.
Indiscriminate use of synthetic pesticides and overdosage of monocrotophos and quinolphos has led so many complications of soil by reducing the fertility levels in soil and increased cost of cultivation, which in turn affected on the farmer by reducing the returns.
Training workshops are held for farmers to teach them inexpensive methods to boost productivity. In this instance, using the oil extract of the neem seed for effective pest control and using vermicompost to enhance soil fertility. IGSSS felt that these interventions would help bring down cost of cultivation and increase returns to the farmer. IGSSS also encourages farmers in this region to practice dual farming. This long-term project involves planting fruit trees at intervals in a field. Saplings are prepared and distributed to the farmers in rotation. Within a few years, farmers can depend on these trees to give them an additional income that will see them through a year, even if their regular crop fails for some reason. The village of Dudyal is on its way to becoming self-sufficient. Besides implementing practices from the sustainable livelihood programs to increase agricultural output, they have also participated in forest management programs. By building check dams and initiating gully control, they have managed to irrigate the entire natural forest reserve. They now use the produce of the forest for income generating activities.
ఇప్పుడు మేము అడవిలో ఉన్నప్పటి నుంచి మాకు పైసలు కూడా డబ్బులు కూలీ లేక మాకు దొరుకుతున్నది ఇప్పుడు ఇట్లనే మా పిల్లలు కూడా భాగం పడుతున్నారు మంచిగానే ఉన్నారు సార్ వాళ్ళందరూ ఇప్పుడు పిల్లలకు బడికి పంపుతున్నాము ఆడ ఈడ ఆమ్ముకుంటున్నాము ఇలిత పండ్లు గిటంగా ఆమ్ముకొని పిల్లలకు బడికి తోలిస్తున్నాం సార్ మేము
Earlier, sending children to school was not a priority. But now, with Lambada women contributing to the family fund, income levels of most families have gone up. The opportunity for the girl child too has opened up, especially since the mother has a say in the decision-making in the house.
ఇట్లనే మేము బాగా చదువుకున్నాక 7వ తరగతి ఫీజు కట్టిపించి మమ్మల్ని పరీక్ష రాసి పాస్ అయినాం మేము పాస్ అయిన తర్వాత ఇట్లనే మీటింగ్లోకి అక్కడిక్కడ వెళ్తే మైసూరు కానీ అక్కడక్కడ వెళ్ళినాం కదా మేము ఇట్లా మీటింగ్లోకి వస్తుంటే చదువుకుంటే అంటారు ఓ మీరు జాబ్ చేస్తారా ఏం కొలువులు చేస్తారు చదువుకున్న వాళ్ళు అంతా ఇక్కడ పడి ఉండరు డిగ్రీల వరకు చదివి కూడా ఏం కొలువులు చేస్తలేరు మీరేం కొలువులు చేస్తారు అని మమ్మల్ని ఇట్లా రోజు తిడుతుండ్రి మీటింగ్లోకి వస్తే మేము చదువుకుంటే గిట్టా మమ్మల్ని తిడుతుండ్రు మీరేం పాస్ అవుతారు అని అంటున్నారు మేము వాళ్ళ ముందర పాస్ అయ్యి చూపించినాం అట్లా అంటే గిట్టా
Many girls like Narsamma are benefiting from income generating programs initiated by IGSSS. Livelihood options that are easily available such as leaf plate making, fruit preservation and also farming related activities like vermicomposting are taught to girls after they have completed their schooling.
నాకు ఎందుకు వచ్చిండ్రేమో అని తెలిసింది నాకు నా కోసం వచ్చిండ్రు అని తెలియదు తెలియకుంటే వచ్చిండ్రు మా అమ్మ నాన్నకు అడిగిండ్రు వాళ్ళు ఇస్తామని ఒప్పుకున్నారు ఒప్పుకుంటే నాకు అడిగిండ్రు నాకు అడిగితే నేను వల్ల నాకు పెళ్ళి ఇప్పుడు అవసరం లేదు నేను వల్ల అని చెప్పిన అవసరం లేదని చెప్తే ఎందుకు వల్లవు ఇంకెన్ని రోజులు ఉంటావు చాలు చదివినకాడికి చాలు పెళ్లి చేసుకో అని అన్నారు నంటే లేదు చదువు ఎంత చదివితే చాలు కాదు నేను చదువుకుంటా ఎంత బేకైతే చదువుకుంటా కానీ పెళ్లి చేసుకోను అని చెప్పిన
8 years ago, Anantamma did not know how to sign her name and had no say in family decisions. After participating in income-generating programs initiated by IGSSS, she is a highly motivated woman today.
Reed samasthala memu ullala kelli antochi itla sangal vettem ullala kelli antochi da training vandinemu training chesi malla ma village lo koi kuda memu itla kashtapadi sar cheppindi kada itla kashtapadi cheskunte bavapadtamemani
Kamli Bai in Boli Bavi Tanda was trained as a birth attendant. She visits pregnant mothers in and around her village to check on nutrition, hygiene and to teach young mothers about family planning options. She encourages regular visits to the local hospital for vaccinations.
ముందు కాన్పు కూడా కమిలి బాయిన చేసింది, ఇంటినే చేసుకున్నా మంచిగా ఉన్నది. రెండో కాన్పు కూడా ఆ బాయిన కమిలి బాయిన చేసింది, మంచిగా ఉన్నది. సంతోషం అయి దవాఖానకు పోయి ఆపరేషన్ చేసుకుని వచ్చిన మాకు సంతోషం ఉన్నది.
ఈయనే చేసి ఈయనే కాన్పు అయి ఈయనే ఆపరేషన్ చేసిన ఖుషితోని నేను. ఇద్దరు కొడుకులు ఉండ, బిడ్డ ఉండ, ఒక బిడ్డ ఒక కొడుకు.
A few years ago, intermarriage between the Lambadas and other communities was unheard of. An example of how perceptions of the outside world have changed within their community is evident in the story of Desha Naik and Reshma's inter-community marriage, something taboo a few years ago. Desha Naik belongs to the Lambada tribe, while Reshma is a Muslim from a family in the main village in the area.
हम एक चाह रहे थे तो अभी वो ये करना बहुत कठिन, बहुत मुश्किल था.
शादी के बाद यहाँ पर आ गए हम लोग. उसके बाद कोई भी कुछ नहीं बोले. इनके इनकी माँ, इनकी मदर, इनके फादर और गांव के लोग कुछ भी नहीं बोले कि आप नहीं. अपनी बेटी के तरह देखें उन लोग भी, और इनके माता जी और इनके पिताजी भी कुछ भी नहीं बोले, और इनके भैया और इनके भाभी सब अपना समझ के चल.
Across state borders in Maharashtra, nomadic communities struggle to gain a foothold on the platform of acceptance in mainstream society as well. The Karmala Taluka has many different nomadic or denotified tribes living within its perimeters in little hamlets. Each tribe has a unique dialect, a different set of customs, and of course, a checkered past, making it much more challenging to work with them cohesively.
Being on the move, they do not belong to any place, and therefore they do not have a ration card, they do not have a domicile certificate, they are not able to put their children to regular school.
Karmala is about 135 kilometers from Sholapur and 165 kilometers from Pune. After India's independence, many denotified tribes settled in its vicinity. They felt that the further away they were from mainstream society, the better off they were. The notoriety of their past and the conscious effort to avoid mainstream society was unfortunately responsible for them being left out of many government schemes and concessions. Some were not even listed on the census because they lived far beyond the periphery of the village, deep in the forests.
As IGSS, we feel very strongly that for groups who we need, the marginalized groups, Adivasis, Dalits and nomadic tribes and denotified tribes are a very important area for our intervention.
Bal Chandra is a Pardhi. His tribe was once labeled criminal. Though no longer branded criminal, Bal Chandra and his tribe are part of the floating population of denotified tribes.
पूर्वी ज्यापासून जन्म त्याने माझा जन्म कुठे झाला, झेलमध्ये झाला. बारामती झेलमध्ये जन्म झाला. फिरते असे भटकते होता. मग भटकते असताना पोलीस डिपार्टमेंटने काय केलेला असता, तो पकडला पारने म्हणजे हकाल चोर करायचा की त्याच्यावर 399 म्हणजे आदर ना उदर ते बाजी बात, त्याला गुन्हा करो ना तर नाही करू.
As recently as 4 years back, Bal Chandra's son Praveen found it difficult to get a job in nearby villages. It was tough providing for a family. In desperation, he turned to crime.
आमच्या समाजातले तरुण पोर असे 10-12 जण टोळ्या करून शानी जात होतो. रेल्वे स्टेशनला जात होतो. दौंड कुर्डवाडी अशा मार्गावर जाणार आम्ही जात होतो. 10-12 जण जात होतो. गेल्यानंतर रेल्वे आल्या की त्याची सिग्नल तोड, कुठं काय तोड, ही कर, हवा सोड, त्याची दगडं तुम टाक, ह्या अशा प्रमाणे केलेलं होतं. आतापर्यंत गाडी पडली की कुठं खिडक्या उघडून ती काय सोनं नाणं काय असं वगैरे वगैरे तोडफेड असं केलं नाही तर पळून आल्यावर त्याच्यामुळं आम्हाला जगायला साधन नव्हती, राहायला जगायला खायला ही नव्हतं, म्हणून आम्ही करायला जात होतो.
Kemane belongs to the nomadic Kaikadi tribe, who are traditionally basket weavers. Fortunate enough to get an education for himself, he got a job as a security officer in a sugar factory. But he felt he needed to do something for his own people.
आणि त्यानंतर मग मी आदिनाथ सहकारी साखर कारखान्याच्या सिक्युरिटी ऑफिसरचा राजीनामा दिला आणि मग 1996 ला महात्मा फुले समाजसेवा मंडळ या संस्थेची आयजीसीचा संपर्क होता आणि त्या ठिकाणी माझी आयजीसीची ओळख झाली म्हणजे भाटक्या कारमा तालुक्यातील भाटके मुक्त जाती जमातीच्या कुटुंबाचं सर्वेक्षण करणे त्यांचे प्रश्न काय आहेत याची माहिती गोळा करणे आणि खऱ्या अर्थानं मग त्यावेळेस आमच्या प्रत्यक्ष कामाला या कामाला सुरुवात झाली.
द फर्स्ट स्टेज ऑफ वर्क वॉज क्रिटिकल. माने हॅड टू फेमिलियराइज हिमसेल्फ अँड हिज स्टाफ टू हँडल सेन्सिटिव्ह इश्यूज. दिस वॉज वेअर द कपॅसिटी बिल्डिंग एक्सरसाइजेस कॅरीड आउट बाय IGSSS प्रूव्ड टू बी अ बिग हेल्प. Soon, Mane was able to conduct training programs on his own.
Since Mane's request matched with IGSS priorities, we decided to go ahead with his request, visit his region, assess the program, and then work on which aspects IGSS could help jointly with Mane to bring the nomadic tribes in his region into the mainstream of society.
मेळा होता एक